Question number 16. We observe weightlessness in a satellite, although a satellite move under Earth's gravity. Explain. Actually, you know that weight is depend upon acceleration due to gravity. That means the pulling force of Earth. It produces an acceleration. If you are moving with an acceleration, 9.8 meter per second square or closer to it, in that case, you feel weightlessness. Weightlessness also you will feel with a high speed lift, which comes downward direction. That means here you feel some, you losing your weight. Why? That means your G value is not exactly 9.8 because you are cancelling it little bit. It's okay? So, we observe weightlessness in a satellite although a satellite move under Earth's gravity. Explain. Because you are moving with an acceleration 9.8 closer, if 9.8 or closer to 9.8, in that case we feel weightlessness. Because exactly 9.8 meter per second square is not, acceleration is not acting on the object, in that case weight is less. You know that weight W is equal to M into G? It's okay? If G value reduces, then weight got reduces. It's okay? Second bit, a ball is thrown up with a velocity 15 meter per second. What is the maximum height attained by the ball? Very easy questions, number of questions I have also discussed in that type. Ball thrown with a speed 15 meter per second means U is equal to 15 meter per second. What is the maximum height attained by it? That means V is equal to 0, A is equal to, G, or G is equal to, it is 9.8 meter per second square. So maximum height attained means you have to find the S. It's okay? That means you have to apply the formula V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. That means V square means 0 minus U square means 15 square is equal to 2 into 9.8 minus into S. It means minus 225 by, it is 19.6, it is also minus, is equal to S. It's okay, you just simplify this, it is 2250 by 196 meter. It's okay.
Define organic farming, state its two advantages. So in organic farming, we're not using artificial fertilizers, artificial pesticides, we're using natural fertilizers, natural pesticides, so better growth, better nutrients to produce quality food. So it's two advantages. First, no artificial fertilizers, artificial pesticides are there, so no harmful for the consumers first. And the quality of the nutrients level will maintain in bio or organic farming fruits, organic farming products.
19. Comment on the following statement. Evaporation causes cooling. Yes, evaporation causes cooling. Because evaporation is a process by which a liquid substance changes to vapor below its boiling point. Okay? Change the state means it needs the latent heat. The latent heat required it takes from the surrounding and change its state. Since it takes the heat from the surrounding, therefore the surrounding get cool or evaporation cause cooling. It's okay? Second, why you observe water droplet outside the ice cold water in a tumbler? Explain reason. In a tumbler, if you are putting ice cold water, you know that in the surrounding water vapors are there. The water vapors which come contact with it, it will get condensed and form water particles. It's okay. Number 20. Compare metal and non-metal based on their physical property. Any four points. That means metal has lustrous, non-metal has no lustrous. Some exceptions are there. Metals are malleable and ductile, non-metals are non-malleable and non-ductile, they are brittle mainly. Metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, non-metals are bad conductor or in some cases poor conductor of heat and electricity. Metals lose electron to form positive ion, non-metals do not lose electron, they gain electron to form negative ion. Another point if you need, number of chemical properties are there. Also you can split the physical property. In metal, non-metal part I have telling you the all the properties. You just see them, okay? Second bit, what are metalloids? Give two examples. Metalloids means the element which has both metal as well as non-metal property. Give two examples, boron and silicon. It's okay? Identify metal from the following. Boron, sodium, mercury, carbon. So sodium and mercury. Boron is metalloid, carbon is non-metal.
Next, question number 21. Give reason for the following. The cells of meristematic tissue have dense cytoplasm, thin walls and prominent nuclei. We have discussed the meristematic tissue is young, have better division capacity. That's why it have a dense cytoplasm and thin wall. And when it become mature, the wall become thicker, thicker. There are two types of cell wall present in plant cells. One is primary cell wall, another is secondary cell wall. Primary cell wall present during beginning time. When it become mature, secondary cell wall will add to the primary cell walls. Three layers of secondary cell wall will add according to increasing its time. And it's a prominent nuclei also. Vacuoles are absent in cell of this tissue. Yes, because of young, high division capacity, all the cell organs are widely present. Cytoplasm is densely arranged. That's why the vacuoles having taking very small space or some cells, vacuoles is also absent.
Number 22. An athlete is moving along a circular path with constant speed. Is the motion is uniform or accelerated? The motion is accelerated. Give reason. Each and every point, you just see the uniform circular motion, you can briefly get the idea about this, okay? In the classroom video, motion chapter, uniform circular motion part, okay? Here I am telling you exact the answer. An athlete moving in a circular path means, with constant speed, means each and every movement, its direction goes changing. In case of circular motion, always the motion is tangent to the path, that means in a straight line. Towards outward, okay? To move in a circular path, each and every moment, its direction goes on changing. Since velocity is related with magnitude as well as direction, therefore, it is a acceleratory motion. It's okay? Second, draw the distance time graph for the following situation. Distance time graph for the following situation. When the body is stationary, that means this is distance. This is time, stationary means this graph. Again, for this better understanding, you see the graph part, okay? Distance, time, graph of a rest object. Second bit, when the body is moving with uniform speed. Again, distance, this is time, moving with uniform speed. It is straight line because the distance increases, okay? When a body is moving with non-uniform speed, in non-uniform speed, the graph you draw, any type, here also, like this or like this or like this, that means you have to draw the straight line. Here, it is a curved path, like this, but never do like this, do not fall downward. You draw a curved path like this, but do not fall downward, because distance never decreases. Question number 23. A motorcyclist riding motorcycle A is traveling with a speed 20 meter per second. Apply the brake and stop the motor car in 10 seconds. Another motorcycle B, who is traveling with a speed 5 meter per second, apply the brake and stop the motorcycle in 20 seconds. Plot the speed time graph for the two motorcycles. Which of the two motorcycles travel further before it comes to stop? It's okay? Little lengthy question, just see, it is a 5-mark question. But this question carry 3 marks. A motorcyclist riding a motorcycle, traveling at a speed 20 meter per second, apply the brake to stop the motorcycle in 10 seconds. Let's say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Like this. This is the speed, this is the time. So, a motorcycle, riding a motorcycle, traveling a speed 20 meter per second, apply the brake and stop the motorcycle in 10 seconds. That means, speed time graph is like this. It's okay? This is your speed, this is your time. Second motorcyclist, traveling with a speed 5 meter per second, apply the brake for the motorcycle and in 20 seconds, that means 14, 16, 18, 20. So from 5 to 20, like this. It is a straight line, okay? Plot the speed time graph for the two motorcycles, it's okay? It's correct? Now, which of the two motorcycles travel further before it comes to rest? That means you have to find the distance. To find the distance, you know that area under the graph. So in first case, distance is equal to area of the triangle, half base 10 into height is 20. That means 100 meter. In second case, half base into height, this is your 20. So distance is equal to half 20 into, this is 5. So 10 is equal to 50 meter. So first case, the distance travel is more. It's okay? It's second bit. A cyclist goes around a circular track once every 2 minutes. If radius of the circular track is 110 meter, calculate the speed of the cyclist. That means 2 pi r by, in circular motion, 2 pi r by t. Means 2 into 22 by 7 into r is 110 meter by t. T means 2 minutes, that is 120 seconds.
Now 24. Mention the desirable characteristics of bees variety in bees keeping. How does pasturage affect the productivity and quality of honey? So there are three varieties of honey bees are there. Three varieties of bees are there. And pasturage affects means we have to provide a proper environmental system to store, to allow the bees to reproduce, to stay and store the honeys. And the honey quality also maintained by these technical procedures. This is a scientific process by which we can increase the bees. There is a special system by which the bees can grow and bees can store honey. So by this process, bees will, there is no fear, external challenges for the bees. So that's a bee can improve, bee can store, and bees can reproduce to demand our honey.
So from question number 27, this is the NCERT activity. When iron fillings and powder sulfur are mixed together in a china dish, which statement is not correct? It is a heterogeneous mixture is formed. Yes, it is correct. The heterogeneous mixture, the constituent present can be seen easily. Yes, the constituent can be separated by magnet. It is also yes, a homogeneous mixture is formed. It is incorrect. It's okay? Second bit, a mixture of iron filling and sulfur, color of the sulfur powder is yellow. This is pale yellow. It's okay? The color of the anhydrous copper sulfate is, copper sulfate actually CuSO4.5H2O. It is copper sulfate pentahydrate. It is blue in color. But on heating it, we'll get CuSO4, copper sulfate, anhydrous copper sulfate, which is colorless. Simply any salt get its color due to presence of water of crystallization. You will read in class 10 also. Water of crystallization, a fixed molecule of water attached physically, okay? It changes the color, or a certain color of the salt is there, okay? But on heating it, you lose the water molecule and get anhydrous salt, which is colorless. It's okay? Here, the color of the anhydrous copper sulfate is white.
While preparing temporary slide, the correct method of placing the cover slip on the specimen. So this is slide. It's a specimen. You want to put one of the cover slip here. By which process you can put the cover slip? First one, dropping the cover slip gently with hand. Slide the cover slip gently from the side. Placing the cover slip gently using forceps. Placing the cover slip gently using needles. That's the right one. D is the right answer. You can place by using needles. You have shown two slides of plant tissues, parenchyma, sclerenchyma. You can identify the sclerenchyma by using, obviously, thickness of the cell wall.
32. The substance which can be separated by sublimation are, sublimation means sublimable substance required. Two liquid having different boiling point, two liquid having same melting point, volatile and non-volatile solid, volatile solid having same melting point. This third one. Volatile and non-volatile solid. 33. The kind of force required to accelerate the motion of a body is unbalanced force. So accelerate the motion of the body means unbalanced force. Gravitational force, though acting, it will not accelerate. If it is freely falling, in that case it is accelerated because various resistive forces are acting on it. Okay? So answer is unbalanced force. A mixture of sand powder, glass, common salt is dissolved in water and then filtered. Name the substance left on the filter paper. Name the substance in the filtrate. It's okay. The substance left on the filter paper means sand not soluble, powdered glass not soluble, common salt is soluble. So mixture of sand and powdered glass will remain on the surface of the filter paper. Name the substance in the filtrate, that is salted water, or in some higher class you will notice that it is known as brine. Okay. Next, in an experiment to determine the boiling point of water, state reason for the following. Pumic stone pieces are added to the water in the beaker. A glass stirrer is used. Pumic stones are added to the beaker means you know that pumic stone mainly reduces the water. That means pumic stone prevents the water from any high amount of bubbling. Actually, that is convection process. When you heat the water, it will start boiling means it will move up and down. That is known as convection method, okay? Bubbling severely. So to prevent this, we are adding pumic stones. Second bit, a glass stirrer is used. Actually, stirrer is used because water is a bad conductor of heat.
Then question number 36, Prakash soaked 6 gram raisins in water after 10 hours, found that the mass of become 9 grams. So you subtract the water absorbed by the raisin and it from its original mass 6 to 9. So mass increased 3 gram, original mass 3 by 6 into 100, and that's your percentage of water absorbed by the raisin, 50%.